Hey there, everyone. I hope you're all doing good. Today, we are going to check out the Surge GTO. So the GTO is the successor of the SSG, the smooth and stepped generator. It means that this module alone, depending on how you flip those switches and how you patch it within itself or with other modules, can do a lot of things, a crazy amount of things. And so the main thing that have been updated compared to the SSG is the ability to go faster and also having 1 volt per octave input, so it becomes much easier to use it as a VCO, which is what we are going to check out first. So if I take the output of this side, plug it over there, I just have to flip that switch that will set it to cycle mode and give me a nice triangle wave. Down the reverb a little bit, just a bit, yeah. Okay, so far so good. You have triangle at this output, square at this output. Okay, just to give you an idea of the range, this is way sub audio. It goes way past human hearing. This side, if you set the switch to the middle, can do exactly the same thing, apart that it has a slightly different range. Goes less high, but I think it goes a bit slower. So, from there, we can do a lot of things with those two together. One of the obvious one is the coupler. The coupler is a comparator between the two channels. So if you set both to cycle and take this output, you get a square wave that change width depending on the relationship between those two. And you can get a lot of different things. Perfect food for filter. Other thing, let's take this one as a VCO, triangle. And we can use it as a sort of a complex oscillator by taking one of the other side to modulate the other. Easy to make some super crazy FM stuff. One of my favorite patch with this kind of thing is to make a sequence. Let's go typical five-step boucle thing. Send that, let's say this one. This one will both send a triangle to FM and square to sync, because we can sync that oscillator. This gives you a lot of weird wave shapes, which can be a bit tamed if you send the same pitch to both. Okay. and of course, lose the FM. And just make the classic sync type sounds. Another typical surge type interaction you can have is to use, for example, this one, send it to the input of this one, and grab the cycle back here. You will just take the square out, you have basically nothing until you reach a certain point where you get that start of oscillation. I love to modulate. Sequences can be fun as well. Can give you some sort of a triggerable sub. Another quite typical surge-like patch is to use one oscillator or related cycling audio thing, and to use this side as a stepped one. This one becomes sort of weird harmonic division kind of thing. Also works differently with the run input. This is a nice thing to sequence. You can bend the waveforms. By feedbacking the outputs into itself, you can make some sort of spiky triangle or so stuff like this. If you use the square, I haven't tried that. Let's use the square as the feedback. I can make some sort. Oh yes, that's awesome. You can make a saw wave oscillator. Perfect saw. Awesome. Didn't know that. Okay, so all the things that I've shown already here can be used as well at control voltage range, meaning you can bend the wave shapes, make those synced FM things to make those weird waveforms and use those as modulation source instead of audio. So one of the other thing that the SSG is known for are the stepped and weird control voltage generation. For example, if I listen to this, let's use a LFO kind of thing here to sweep that wave shape. We have that old input, which can be used to stop the oscillation at some point. Which means this becomes a track and hold. It oscillates, but it stops when it receives something at old input. So you don't even have to feed something in, but you can if you feed anything to the input. So here it will slew the voltage. We'll talk about this later on. And if you send something to the old, it'll start to stop it. And this becomes the general slewness of things. It's easy to make some kind of stepped but smooth random voltages. On the other end, the stepped side, if you put it to cycle then into the upper register here, will wait until it receives something in the sample input to act. So let's send some of these pulse here. Set the rate to the max so there's no slewing. And the cool thing about this is that it makes some kind of patterns. The patterns will be different depending on both the rate and the speed you set over there. It's easier to hear it on the pitch. Like the other, you can not cycle it and just send whatever you want to the input to use it as a sample and hold. It can be noise to get full random, and this becomes a sort of slew of the internal sampling, which doesn't make the step smoother. It just grab less information, basically. One fun thing. Let's make a sequence. Use the ref as an envelope. Low pass. That, now that it's very capable at audio rate, this can be used as a very nice sample rate reducer for audio. So let's patch this inside. So if I use this, this is just some kind of filter. If I flip that, I have nothing because it's waiting for something at the sample or run input. So let's feed it something. Let's use that oscillator. See? Past a certain point, it doesn't do much. That's the difference with the run input. Run input does have a different range, so you can further pixelate your waveforms. This is different, but of course this is voltage controllable. So you can feed whatever you want. Also voltage control your clock source. A lots of fun again here. One thing I haven't shown yet is that you can use one side as a low-pass gate filter type of thing. If you don't put it in cycle mode, send that to the input, yes, and put it to the smooth side, smooth mode. The rate does act as a mixture of amplitude and frequency content modulation. It does have a very weird sound that I like, actually. So of course, these are also slew generators, so let's patch that in. Let's send sequence here. So to slew that sequence, you can send it to one side, and smooth here, send input, output, back to 1 volt per octave. And as this is voltage controllable, you could have it set to a different slew rate on each step. Which is always fun. This side is the oscillator, this side the slew, controlled both by 245. I guess that's it for this tour of the GTO. There's probably lots of things that I forgot. But, I mean, it does so many things. It's a very nice and very handy module, and it sounds awesome as an oscillator, like all this kind of circuit from the Surge world. That's what set them apart from other things like this, for example, which are not that good sounding when you use them as VCOs. Well, those can really be like LFOs, VCOs, filters, whatever, every time with a very distinct color. Actually, the VCOs are not colored at all. That's why they sound awesome, I think. They really sound like laboratory equipment type of super precise thing. Anyway, I love those. And also, as it's dual, you can use both sides as filters and then mix them. I mean, it's just infinite. Well, that's it. GTO, thanks to Random Source to have sent me this. I got it for just a lowered price, but I still paid for it. And no one asked me to do this video. I'm just doing it because I think it's helpful to others. Goodbye. I'll try to make a little sample pack out of this for my Patreon subscribers. Thanks to everyone who is already supporting me there. See you next time. Bye-bye.